हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एनएसबी लर्निंग हब, बिकॉज द लर्निंग इज लाइफ। माय सेल्फ मीनाक्षी आहूजा। टुडे वी स्टडी द साइंस चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 9th, फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ, सेल। वी कैन स्टडी सेल एंड सेल ऑर्गेनेल्स इन द ब्रांच ऑफ साइंस कॉल्ड साइटोलॉजी। Cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Why cell is called structural unit? Because all the organism from smallest to largest, simplest to complex, unicellular to multicellular are made up of cells. That's why cell is called the structural unit. And all the life activities are performed in it. That's why it is called the functional unit of life. All the living organism is made up of microscopic unit cells called unit cells. The cells has the same central position in biology as the atom has in physical sciences. See this structure. This is the structure of onion peel cells. It show nucleus, cytoplasm, cell membrane, and all the cells are the same size. Now, the next topic is discovery of the cells. First of all, Robert Hooke, who is known as the father of cytology. Robert Hooke in 1665 saw the cells for the first time in the thin slice of cork with his simple microscope. In the thin slice of cork, what is cork? Cork obtained from the bark of a tree. He observed them as honeycomb like structure and named them cellula. It is the Latin word for a little room. Now it is called cells in biology. Robert Hooke ne jab कॉर्क स्लाइस को माइक्रोस्कोप में देखा था, तब उन्होंने हनीकॉम लाइक स्ट्रक्चर देखे और उन्होंने उसको नाम दिया सेलुला, जिसका लैटिन में अर्थ होता है छोटा, छोटे छोटे रूम। बाद में इन्हीं छोटे छोटे रूमों को सेल नाम दिया गया। नेक्स्ट, एंटोनी वॉन लेवनहॉक इन 1674 विद द इम्प्रूव्ड माइक्रोस्कोप ऑफ हिमसेल्फ डिस्कवर द फ्री लिविंग सेल्स इन पॉन्ड वाटर For the first time, he studied living cells as bacteria, protozoa, RBC, etc. Now, Robert Brown in 1831 discovered nucleus in the cell. J.E. Purkinje in 1839 used the term protoplasm for the living substance present inside the cell. Next important topic is cell theory. All the plants and animals are composed of cells, and that the cell is the basic unit of life. Cell theory was presented by two biologists, Schiedin in 1838 and Schwann in 1839. However, this theory did not explain as to how new cells were formed. Actually, Schiedin is the German botanist. And he said that all the plants is made up of cells. And Schwann is the British zoologist, and he said that all the animals are made up of cells. Both of them together perform the cell theory that all the organelles are made up of cells, but they cannot explain how new cells were formed. Next, Rudolf Virchow in 1855 first explained that cells divided and new cells are formed from pre-existing cells. And he said this process named as omnicellular e-cellula. He modified the hypothesis of Schiedin and Schwann to give the cell theory a final shape. According to the modern cell theory, now all the living organisms are composed of cells and product of cells. Next, all the cells arise from the pre-existing cells. After that, electron microscope discovered and in 19 discovered, and the all cell organelles are studied under the complex electron microscope. Unicellular and multicellular organism. All cells, whether they exist as one-celled unicellular organism or as the multicellular organism, are capable of carrying out certain basic functions such as nutrition, respiration, growth and reproduction. These both functions are life functions, living functions. These functions are essential for the survival of the cells. Cellular organism, unicellular organism and multicellular organism. Differentiate between unicellular and multicellular organism. An unicellular organism is represented by a single cells, but a multicellular organism consists of large number of cells. All activities of the organism are performed by a single cells. A single cell performs one or few activities of the organism. There is no division of labor, as the single cell performs all life activities. Cells are specialized to perform different functions of the body, so as there is division of labor within the cells. Reproduction consumes a single cell. Only some cells of the body, called germ cells, take part in the reproduction. Other cells, somatic cells, remain intact. The life of an individual is short in unicellular organism, and lifespan of the individual is long in multicellular organism. Example of unicellular organism are amoeba, paramecium, chlamydomonas, and bacteria. An example of fungi, example of multicellular organism are fungi, plants, and animals. Now, activity. This activity is onion peel activity. We mount the temporary slide of onion peel to show the cell structure. Let us take a small piece of the onion bulb with the help of pair of forceps. We can peel off the skin called epidermis from the inner layer of the onion. Onion ke andar ki taraf jo membrane hoti hai usko inner epidermis bolte hain. Usko nikalna hota hai. This layer can be put immediately in the watch glass containing water. Aur usko jaldi se water ke andar rakh dete hain jo ki watch glass mein hota hai taki wo dry na ho sake. This layer can be put immediately in watch glass containing water. This will prevent the peel from getting folded or getting dry. Usko fold hone se aur dry hone se bachati hai. Let us make a glass slide, put a drop of water on it and transfer the small piece of peel from the water glass to slide. Make sure that peel is perfectly flat on the slide. A thin camel hair paint brush might be necessary to help to transfer the peel. Now we put a drop of saffron solution on this piece followed by a cover slip. Take care to avoid the air bubbles while putting the cover slip with the help of mounting needles. Now we can observe this light under low power followed by high power of a compound microscope. We observe these structure look similar in each other. Together they form big structure like an onion bulb. We find from this activity that onion bulb of different sizes have similar small structure visible under a microscope. The dark points visible are called nucleus. Activity 5.2. Try to prepare temporary mount of the leaf peel, strip the roots of the onion and revel even peel of the onion of different sizes. Take a leaf of maize, mustard and tradescantia. With a sudden jerk, a small segment can be peeled off from the lower surface of the leaf. Make a temporary mount of this peel and observe under the microscope. What we observe? On observation, we know that the cells of multicellular organisms are different in shape and size. cells of different organism are different. The cells of different parts of a multicellular organism are also different in shape, size, and structure. Basic similarity among the cells of higher organism are they have the plasma membrane, cytoplasm, and organelles and a nucleus. Different shape and size of the cells. So the size and shape of the cells are ultimately determined by the specific function of the cells. Size and shape depend on the functions of the cells. Some cells can change their shape like amoeba and WBC. Amoeba, you know, irregular shape ke hote hain. Pseudopodia, food lene ke liye apna size change karte rehte hain. Similarly, WBC bhi jo hoti hain, wo phagocytes hoti hain. Hamare body mein jo foraging particles aa jate hain, unko khane ka kaam karti hain apne pseudopodia se. That's why ye dono apne size and shape change karte rehte hain. While most of the plants and animal cells have almost fixed shape. Some of the cells can be seen with naked eyes, but great majority of the cells are too small to be seen by the naked eyes. So we can see them through the microscope only. Smallest cell जो होती है, उसको PPLO या mycoplasma बोलते हैं. PPLO मतलब pleuronemia-like organism. Pleuronemia-like organism. Largest cells ostrich egg. Longest animal cells जो होता है वो nerve cells होता है. This is next cell organization. Non-cellular organism. The organism that do not contain any cell in their body organization, such as viruses. Viruses are the connective link between the living and non-living. They are non-cellular organism. Virus lack any membrane and hence do not show characteristic of life until they enter the living body to use its cell machinery to reproduce. ये host की body में जाकर reproduce करता है, अपने numbers को बढ़ाता है. Without human body या without living body ये non-living होता है, crystal form में रहता है. जैसे ही ये host के अंदर आता है वैसे ही ये living हो जाता है. Cellular organism. The organisms that contain either one or more cells in their bodies, such as bacteria, plants, and animals. Cellular organisms are again divided into two types, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes. These organisms have primitive and incomplete cells. ये primitive होती हैं, सबसे पहले की cells हैं जो पहले मिलती थीं, और incomplete होती हैं. Prokaryotic cells lack prokaryotes lack nuclear membrane around their genetic substance DNA. इसका जो genetic material होता है DNA या RNA, उसके चारों तरफ nuclear membrane नहीं होती है, यानी कोई मतलब इसका definite nucleus नहीं होता है इसमें. Nuclear material of the prokaryotic cell consists of single chromosomes, which is in डायरेक्ट कॉन्टैक्ट विद द साइटोप्लाज्म. और इसमें जो क्रोमोसोम भी जो होता है वो सिंगल होता है और वो डायरेक्ट कॉन्टैक्ट में होता है साइटोप्लाज्म के. साइटोप्लाज्म क्या होता है? जो लिक्विड होता है सेल के अंदर. दिस अनडिफाइंड न्यूक्लियर रीजन इन द साइटोप्लाज्म इज कॉल्ड न्यूक्लियॉइड. इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? न्यूक्लियॉइड बोलते हैं. इन प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल अदर मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड ऑर्गेनेल्स आर एब्सेंट. ऑर्गेनेल्स भी एब्सेंट होते हैं, जो मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड ऑर्गेनेल्स होते हैं लाइक माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया गॉल्जी बॉडीज वगैरह. राइबोसोम्स हाउएवर प्रेजेंट इन प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल्स. राइबोसोम्स जो होते हैं ये भी टू टाइप्स के होते हैं. प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल्स में अलग होते हैं 70S टाइप के, जबकि यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स में 80S टाइप के होते हैं. इसके बारे में आप बड़ी क्लासेस में पढ़ेंगे. सेल डिवीजन टेक प्लेस बाय द फिशन और बडिंग. सेल डिवीजन सिंपल होता है फिशन या बडिंग से. द प्रोकैरियोट्स इंक्लूड आर्ची बैक्टीरिया, बैक्टीरिया एंड साइनोबैक्टीरिया. दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ अ प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल. न्यूक्लियोइड, फ्लैजलम जिसके हेल्प से ये मूव करते हैं, मेसोसोम्स की हेल्प से रेस्पिरेशन करते हैं, राइबोसोम प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस का में हेल्प करता है. नाउ यूकैरियोट्स. These have advanced and complete cells. These cells contain membrane-bound nuclei and other cellular organelles and are called eukaryote cells. इसमें complete nucleus होता है, nucleus के चारों तरफ nuclear membrane होती है और other organelles भी होते हैं जो कि membrane bound होते हैं, like mitochondria, Golgi body, ribosomes. Such cells are found in unicellular and multicellular organisms and contain plasma membrane, nucleus, DNA, cytoplasm with ribosomes and cellular organelles such as mitochondria, plastid, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, lysosome, etc. All are present. Now differentiate between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotics, the size of the cell is generally small, 1 to 10 millimeter. In eukaryotic cells, the size of the cell is generally large, 5 to 100 millimeter. In prokaryotic cells, nucleus is absent. Nucleoid is not surrounded by the nuclear membrane. True nucleus is absent. True nucleus is present. Means nuclear membrane is present around the genetic material. It contains single chromosome, histone protein absent. It contains more than one chromosome, histone protein present. Nucleus is absent, nucleolus is absent. What is nucleolus? Nucleolus is a part of nucleus. I will explain it in further videos. Nucleolus is present. Membrane-bound cell organelles are absent. Membrane-bound cell organelles are present. Examples of prokaryotic cells are Archaebacteria, bacteria, cyanobacteria, and the examples of eukaryotic cells are plants and animal cells. Some cells are called mesokaryotic cells. Dinoflagellate, a type of algae, are the example of mesokaryotic cells. In these cells, histone protein absent, but the nucleus is present. Cell division by dinomitosis. Dinomitosis, cell division is two types, mitosis and meiosis. I will explain it. Term mesokaryotes was used by Tost. Okay, friends. In next video, we will study for the structure of cell. Thank you. Bye-bye.